By the grace of Allah, by the grace of Allah, even the darkest night will end, and the sun will rise and shine, and the sun will rise and shine. By the grace of Allah.
Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله. My dear brothers and viewers of Rise and Shine, welcome to Rise and Shine. Alhamdulillah, that's the name of our program. We have this each and every weekday, my dear brothers, from Mondays to Fridays. We try to begin our day initially, each and every single day, alhamdulillah, we begin by listening to the beautiful verses of the glorious Quran. We also have the Na'at of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a daily reminder, a daily hadith. As usual, my dear brothers, let's begin by listening to the beautiful تلاوت of the Quran. صلوا على الحبيب صلى الله تعالى على محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علم الشمس والقمر بالحسبان والنجم والشجر والسماء رفعها ووضع الميزان ألا صدق الله العظيم.
صلوا على الحبيب صلى الله تعالى على محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم. My dear brothers and viewers of Madani Channel, Alhamdulillah, you are watching Rise and Shine. Yes, Alhamdulillah, you know, it is early morning. Many of you may have just got out of your beds. But don't forget, today is a special day. Why? Because it is a Friday today. Today, the day of Eid, my dear brothers and viewers of Madani Channel. Now, Alhamdulillah, as usual, we have a new topic each and every single day. What is today's topic? It is said about today's topic, the ihdharu, that beware of, protect yourself from, do not go close to al-ajalata. Do not go close to, my dear brothers, or beware of being hasty. Why? فَإِنَّهَا تُثْمِرُ النَّدَامَ. Because for indeed hastiness, this only bears the fruit of regret. Yes, my dear brothers, whenever we perform any action in a hasty manner, my dear brothers and viewers of Madani Channel. Meaning, what does it mean by hasty? Inshallah, we'll find out very soon. But It only leads in regret. This is what you must remember. Let's turn to a naat of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa ala alihi wasallam. MashaAllah, for that also we have our beloved Azim Bhai. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa ala alihi wasallam.
Sallallahu alayka ya رسول الله وسلم عليك يا حبيب الله اللہ کی سرتاب قدم شان گئے انسان ہی انسان وہ انسان گئے انسان گئے انسان وہ انسان گئے قرآن تو ایمان قرآن تو ایمان بتاتا ہے انہیں اور ایمان یہ کہتا صلی اللہ علیہ یا رسول اللہ وسلم علیہ یا حبیب اللہ سرور کہو کے مالک مالا کہو تجھے
جانے تو ہسا دائیں عشق بھی تو چاہے
ਛੱਡ ਜਾਣੇ ਵੀ ਤੂੰ ਸਾਡਾ ਦਿਲ ਵੀ ਤੂੰ ਦਿਲਦਾਰ ਵੀ ਤੂੰ ਹਾਂ ਕੁਲ ਨਬੀਆਂ ਦਾ ਸੁਲਤਾਨ ਵੀ ਤੂੰ ਨਾਲੇ ਅਰਸ਼ਾਦਾ ਮਹਿਮਾਨ ਵੀ ਤੂੰ ਨਾਲੇ ਅਰਸ਼ਾਦਾ ਮਹਿਮਾਨ ਵੀ ਤੂੰ ਮੁੱਖ ਦੀ ਗੱਲ ਮੁਕਾ ਦੇਵਾ ਤੇ ਮੁੱਖ ਦੀ ਗੱਲ ਮੁਕਾ ਦੇਵਾ ਸਾਡਾ ਦਿਨ ਵੀ ਤੂੰ ਤੇ ਮਾਨ ਵੀ ਤੂੰ ਹੈ ਜਾਣੇ 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 ਤਜੱਲਾ اللہ کی سرتا بقدم شان گئے ارے انسان گئے انسان وہ انسان گئے قرآن تو ایمان بتاتا میری جان گئے جانے 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 تجلا کروں تجھے قربان میں ان کی بخشش کے مقصد بھی زبان پر آنے لگے قربان میں ان کی بخشش کے مقصد بھی زبان پر آنے لگے بن مانگ دیا رت ندیا دامن میں ہمارے سمایا لگے بن مانگ دیا اور اتنا دیا دامن میں ہمارے سمایا لگے ایمان ملا وہ کیا گے جو ہم نے پایا نہیں ہے جانے 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 تجلا کروں تجھے اور تیرے وصف عیب تنہائی سے بری کیا کیا کہوں تجھے حیران ہوں میرے شاہ میں کیا کیا کہوں تجھے کہہ لے گی سب سب ان کے سنا خان کی خاموشی چپ ہو رہا ہوں کہ میں کیا کیا کہوں تجھے لیکن رسان خط میں سخن اس پہ کر دیا میرے رسان خط میں سخن اس پہ کر Come, come, come. تجھے سرور کہوں کہ مالک مولا کہوں تجھے
صلو علی الحبیب صلی اللہ تعالی علی محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم. الله أكبر. يا رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم. What should we call you? الله أكبر. What can we call you? No doubt our words can never grant justice to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, to his excellence, to his brilliance, to his magnificence, my dear brothers and viewers of Madani Channel. No. But what we can say is خالق کا بندہ. Allah, 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 Allah. But what we can say is, yes, he is the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And at the same time, خلقك آكاك هون تجي. Yes, he is the servant of the creator of the universe. But for the rest of us, for the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is our آقَى. He is our messenger. This is Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and viewers of Madani Channel, you are watching Rise and Shine. MashaAllah, we began our day, our Friday, with the blessed virtues, Allahu Akbar, the virtuous ayat of the Holy Quran. We have listened to the Quran and then listened to a naat of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And now we shall move on to our topic. So stick with us to find out more on that. First, let's move to our topic. Our topic for today is hastiness, being hasty. What does it mean by being hasty? Let's ask our Ammar bhai. Ammar bhai, jazakallahu khairah for joining us. You know, the topic of the day is hastiness. What does that mean?
Hastiness, this is a very, very relevant topic because we live in a society which is a fast-paced society. Everything happens so quickly. We want everything so quickly. So if we were to look at when we're speaking about hastiness today, what we mean by that is rushing into things without a contemplation, without pondering over the consequences and the long-term impacts of this action. We jump into something, rushing into something. On the other hand, tawakkuf and contemplation would be when you take steps towards an action after having contemplated, after having thought about something, the consequences of that action, the long-term effects of that action. So this is what we mean by hastiness. Because, you know, like in this day and age, like, well, generally, as part of our nature, human nature, we want success. Who doesn't want to be successful?
Allah,
be that in terms of his, in terms of the world, be that in terms of religion, everybody's wanting success as it means to them, whatever success is for them. But if we are hasty, this is something that prevents us. For example, take the example of somebody in the world. They carry out an action and they want instant results.
Allah.
And when they don't see it, they give up. Because they're hasty, they want to see results straight away. They don't realize that no matter what we do, it adds up over time. It adds up over time. Like somebody saving, let's say if he earns 500 a week,
right,
and he saves 100, every week he saves 100. Now after 4 weeks, if he says, why don't I have 4,000? He knows that's not possible, because it is going to add up. Eventually he'll get there if he continues and he keeps at it. But if he wants it instantly, after investing 100 for 4 weeks, saving 100 for 4 weeks, he knows it's unrealistic to expect 4,000. And this, in this example, he knows it's unrealistic. But we forget that when it's in our life, when we do something and we forget that it is unrealistic.
Allah, Allah, Allah.
We're hurrying into things. We cannot expect results so quickly. When we try to, when a parent tries to advise his son, after 2 days he says, but he's not listening, there's no hope. It's unrealistic if he's been doing something for 10 years, that you tell him for 2 days,
Allah,
and all of a sudden he's going to have a change of the heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can change his heart.
Allah, Allah, Allah.
But you know, realistically speaking,
yes,
if he's been at it for the last 10, 20 years, what makes you think that you give him two sentences and that is totally going to turn him upside down. It's just, it's not possible. So this is what we mean by hastiness. We want results so quickly. We want results instantly. We want everything instantly. We want shortcuts. Be that in terms of wealth, be that in terms of any task that we do, be that even in terms of religion sometimes. That, you know, we want to, ma'adallah, finish our prayer quickly. When we start, we want to finish it quickly. Hurry in that. So these are things, inshallah, we'll tackle as we go on. But this is what we mean by hastiness, that this constant search for everything so quick, so fast.
And that's why we say, you know, especially here in the United Kingdom, Allahu Akbar, and some brothers and views on the channel. For those, you know, it is a morning program, but especially for those within the United Kingdom, it's a morning program. You know, we're always looking for quick things, aren't we? Quick food, as we say, you know, quick food, or well, fast food is what we call it, not quick food. We call it fast food, you know, fast cars we want. We like quick service, fast service, and that's where, you know, we would give somebody a 5-star. Everything we like so quickly, my dear brothers and viewers, this is what we are, and there's something which is classed as the millennials, you know, which are quite famous nowadays. We call them the millennials, my dear brothers and viewers. What are the millennials? The millennials, but people do, you know, define millennials in different ways. Some say those who, you know, were born in 1985 and onwards, or even 1974, etc. and onwards, meaning the young generation, you can say. This new generation who is known as the millennials, my dear brothers. What is it about these people where, you know, their parents have told them from when they were young that, you know, you can do anything. You can be anyone you want. You can have anything you wish for. You know, and this is what has been embedded within their minds, where they think, you know, if I want it, I can have it. No, not earning for it. Not that you'll have to work for it and then you shall earn it. No, if you want it, you can have it. You deserve it. You deserve everything. My dear some brothers and viewers, inshallah, especially those of you that are parents out there, these are not the things we should be teaching our children, no. But they must work for things, and after working for things, they shall gain satisfaction, they shall gain results. Not that, you know, instantly whatever you wish you can have, no. You know, the world is yours. No, my dear some brothers, it's not like that. Because what's going to happen? You're going to teach them these things, they're going to go to school and they're going to learn. You know, I want this. No, you can't have it. This is what they're going to learn. Now, just because I want it is not a good enough reason for me to be given it. I must earn it. You know, sometimes people want results. You want good results, you must earn it. You don't just gain it like that, you know, with the flicking of your fingers.
But, you know, even if you look at the media and the way we're being marketed to, the advertisement that we, you know, that we are exposed to. Because, you know,
we become a millionaire in a week.
Yeah, because we're searching for everything so quickly. So even the advertising is faced like this, like lose this many pounds, lose this many kilograms, this many kilos within 2 weeks.
Get a six pack in a week.
Yeah, and get this in a week and get this in 2 days. Learn this language within 7 days. Yeah. And obviously, realistically speaking, a lot of that is just a quick way of taking our money. And at the end, there's like some loophole, like, oh, what we meant is get this much efficiency in the language, which you do have. But the way we're sold to, you know, it is appealing to that quick manner of ours, that hastiness of ours. And this is what we're being sold to again and again.
And Marva, this is the reason why so many people, they are not satisfied with their jobs. He said that, you know, a person, he works at a place for 6 months and he says he wants to leave. When he was asked, why do you wish to leave? You know what he says? He says, my dear brothers and viewers on the channel, he says, because, you know, I thought that when I was going to come to this job, you know, I was going to change things, you know, I was going to do something, you know, they think they're going to change the world, you know, within
like
6 months.
Weeks.
And these brothers, it doesn't work like that. Things happen slowly. Things happen over time. There's that saying of about the shaitan, isn't it? About hastiness. If you could please share that with us.
Allah, but, you know, firstly, because we're speaking about hastiness, somebody might be thinking that, well, what has this got to do with Islam? It's in terms of being an Islamic topic. So alhamdulillah, we do have guidelines from our regarding everything. So the Prophet ﷺ firstly guides us, and he says that al-anatu min Allah wal-ajlatu min ash-shaytan, that pondering and contemplation is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and hastiness is from the devil, from the Satan, from the shaitan. So we find, you know, hastiness, that the shaitan, he also places hastiness within us. So this is a beautiful saying of Shaykh al-Islam, Shahabuddin Imam Ahmad bin Hajar Makki, Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala. He says that even though hastiness is from the shaitan,
Allah,
hastiness is from the devil, but the shaitan himself is not hasty.
Allah, Allah, Allah.
You know, such a deep point that hastiness is from the shaitan, but the shaitan himself is not hasty.
Marba, this
he
is
takes
so,
a
so
person,
deep.
He takes a person through a process, through some steps, and leads him towards evil, and the person does not even feel it.
Allah,
the person does not even realize it. Because the shaitan did not haste, he did not hurry in taking him towards that evil. He took him through steps.
Marba, I want you to repeat this point again, inshallah, and expand on this point after Madisa and Brothers and Views on the channel. We have turned to our next segment of the day. What is the next segment? Those who regularly watch Rise and Shine will know. Those who don't should watch Rise and Shine regularly. And also, please share it with the rest of the individuals that you do know. Please share this. Alhamdulillah, you know, each and every single day, each and every single weekday, we are, mashallah, the majority of the time live from Madison Brothers and Views on the channel, from Bradford, for Rise and Shine each and every single morning. Let's turn to our next segment, which is a daily reminder. Sallu ala al-Habib, sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam.
By the grace of Allah, by the grace of Allah.
If we ask any Muslim, would you like to achieve salvation on the Day of Judgment? They will say, of course we do. What kind of question is that? That day regarding which the ulama-i kiram have told us that the sun will be brought closer, and the ahadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam inform us that people will be drowning in their sweat according to their sins, some up to their ankles and some, ma'adallah, even up to their necks. Now on that day, that most difficult day, how to achieve salvation? Do you know that there will only be one shade on that day when there will be no other shade? The only shade will be the shade of the throne of Allah. That will be the only shade. Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal, our merciful Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us beforehand who will be under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's throne. Made things easier for us, that in this life we can prepare for that day and ensure that we are under that shade. So let me relay a hadith from Bukhari and Muslim, wherein the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam tells us about seven very fortunate individuals who will be under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's throne on that day. Number one, a just ruler. Somebody who was given that status of being a ruler, and he was just. He was a munsif. He did not commit crimes. He was not oppressive towards people. Number two, a young man who grows up worshipping his Lord. Number three, a man whose heart is attached to the masjid. Subhanallah. Number four, two men who love one another for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, and they meet and part on that very basis, because of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A man who is called by a woman of rank and great beauty, but he says, I fear Allah Azza wa Jal. And number six, a man who gives into charity and conceals it to such an extent that his left hand does not know what his right hand gave. And number seven, a man who remembers Allah Azza wa Jal when he is alone and his eyes fill up, meaning he cries in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now just ponder, dear viewers of Madini channel, are we doing those actions that will guarantee us the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's throne? Are we amongst those who, if we have been given a mansab, a status, and we're a ruler, are we just? Are we amongst those who are in our youth and are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Are we amongst those whose hearts are attached to the masjid? And these masajid have been mentioned as the best places on earth. Are our hearts attached to the masajid? Do we love people for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Or is it because of worldly interests? I'm his friend because he will benefit me in this situation or that situation. Are we amongst those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and when invited towards sin by the opposite gender, we say we fear Allah? Or do we fall into sin? Are we amongst those who give in charity, but then when we give in charity, we tell everyone? Or are we amongst those who conceal it, as mentioned in the Hadith Sharif, and the right hand gives, the left hand doesn't even know about it? Or are we amongst those people who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when alone, and we cry, we shed tears in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because these are those actions that will guarantee us the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's throne. Life is short, we must ensure that we're doing these actions. So on that day when people are in great difficulty, we inshallah azza wa jal are in comfort, peace, and free from all calamities.
By the grace of Allah, by the grace of Allah.
Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. MashaAllah, that was our daily reminder, my dear Islam brothers and viewers of Madinah, inshallah. And today the topic, for those of you that may have joined us late, is being hasty, my dear Islam brothers. MashaAllah, we've heard the saying that, you know, hastiness is from shaitan. But although hastiness, being hasty, meaning, rushing things, going into things without thinking, you know, just rushing into things. Although being hasty is from the shaitan himself is not hasty. Allahu Akbar, this is so deep if you truly understand this. Subhanallah. You know, why? Because the shaitan, you know, in his own work, he is successful. In the task that he has brought upon himself, the task to misguide people, he is brilliant at it. Although mazallah is wrong and is totally against the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is accursed. But his task, what is his task? His task is to take us off the deen, and he is, you know, he is successful, you can say, in his own task. Why, my dear brothers? He is not hasty. Amarbai, please do expound on that point.
Allah, well, there are so many ways to explain this. You know, if we, depending on, it's Friday today, so we might have some youngsters. We might have some youngsters, hopefully, watching. But let's say, even, you know, how a person gets involved in drugs, right? Now, his parents may have brought him up thinking, explaining to him that drugs are bad. You should never go near them. So he knows this. And then, now the shaitan is not going to take him towards haram things and haram drugs straight away. That's not the first thing that the shaitan is going to take him through. The shaitan is going to take him through a set of some steps. So for example, first, he'll give him the company of such people who are involved in things like this. And he will justify to himself. He'll think, well, I'm not doing anything. I'm just with these guys. I'm not bad. So now, he has taken you there. He didn't rush. He didn't straight away tell you to go for the big shot and, you know, do this and do that. Rather, he took you in that friend circle first. Then, from there, maybe he'll get involved in just something like a cigarette. So it's not going on to the, you know, extreme sort of drugs, but this is a starting point. The actual starting point was you affiliating yourself with such people, and then you start to smoke cigarettes, and then the person just continues and continues, and before you know it, he's addicted, he's hooked onto these things. And then those friends disperse, those friends leave him. You know, that same friend who would buy him these things, now they leave him, but now his body wants it. Now he needs it himself. And this is how, from a religious point of view as well, when a person does so much worship, you know, let's say a person who prays five daily salah every single day in the first row. And the shaitan's not going to come and try to make him miss all his five salah straight away. Because the shaitan is not going to rush into it. But he will take him through the same sort of steps. He'll tell him, oh, you know, today you're feeling tired. Sunnah غير مؤكدة. You pray your sunnah مؤكدة and غير مؤكدة. غير مؤكدة, it's alright. You know, you can leave it.
No harm in missing it once in a while.
So you should miss it. If today you give it a miss, you're tired. And now he thinks, you know, this is harmless. It's not like I'm gaining any sins. So it's true, I'm tired today. Now, it doesn't sound like harmful advice. It doesn't sound like dangerous advice. So he does this. After a while of this, him doing this, now the shaitan comes to him again. You know, okay, look, it's sunnah mu'akkada, but you're really, really tired today. You haven't missed it in ages. Just once out of the blue, miss it. It can't be that bad. So then he misses that. Then now the person shifts from the first row to like the third row. And then he's starting to miss one rak'ah. First, he get all his rak'ah, all his units and cycles of prayer with the congregation. Now he's starting to miss them. And then before you know it, he's starting to miss his entire jama'at, his entire congregation. Then he's starting to miss one salah. He's only praying four. But he's still comparing himself to somebody lower than him. He's only praying three. At least I'm doing four. He does not realize where the shaitan has taken him from. Because the shaitan has done it so gradually, he hasn't let him realize.
Allah.
And all the time he's thinking, no, I'm good, because that guy's only praying three, I'm praying four. But he doesn't realize I was praying five in the first row before. What has happened to me? Because the shaitan has not let him realize. And this is what is meant, that the shaitan, hastiness is from the shaitan, but the shaitan himself is not hasty.
He's not hasty, Allah.
He will take you to sins without you even realizing. And he will take his time.
SubhanAllah. My dear brothers and viewers of Madani channel, you are watching Rise and Shine each and every single day. Yes, we have a reminder, and subsequent to the reminder, we also have something else. What is this? It is the daily hadith, mashallah, Abu Abdullah Madani Sahib. Let's take a look. Abu Abdullah Bhai has for us today. Sallu ala al-habib, sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam.
By the grace of Allah, by the grace of Allah.
Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Dear viewers of Rise and Shine, in today's daily hadith, we will hear about a very special day, a very blessed day, a day which has been called Sayyidul Ayyam. Which is this day? It is narrated on the authority of Sayyidina Salman al-Farsi radiallahu ta'ala an, that Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, لَا يَكْتَسِلُ رَجُلٌ يَوْمَ الْجُمْعَةِ وَيَتَتَحَّرُ مَسْتَطَاءَ مِنْ تُهْرٍ, that whoever takes a bath on the day of Friday purifies himself as much as he can, وَيُدَحِّنُ مِنْ دُهْنِهِ وَأَوْ يَمَسُّ مِنْ تِيبِ بَيْتِهِ, and then applies oil and perfumes himself from the scent of his house. ثُمَّ يَخْرُجُ فَلَا يُفَرِّقُ بَيْنَ اثْنَيْنِ, and then he proceeds towards the Jummah prayer and does not separate two sitting people, i.e. in the masjid. ثُمَّ يُسَلِّي مَا قُتِبَ لَهُ, and then he performs whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed for him. ثُمَّ يُنْسِتُ إِذَا تَكَلَّمَ الْإِمَامِ, and he remains silent while the Imam speaks. Then what is the reward for this type of individual? It is mentioned, إِلَّا غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَ جُمْعَةِ الْأُخْرَى, then his present and the previous Jum'ah that he has performed, all the sins committed between these two Jum'ahs will be forgiven. SubhanAllah, what a great virtue one can attain by honoring this blessed day of Jum'ah, that all his sins could be wiped out. No doubt every moment of the day and night of Jum'ah are full of blessings, and we should make extra efforts in order to reap these phenomenal blessings by acting upon these tasks mentioned in this blessed hadith, alongside various other things that we can do on Yawmul Jum'ah mentioned in other narrations. Also, we should try to read the very informative booklet of Amir Ahl Sunnah Damat Barakatum Al-Aliya entitled The Blessings of Jum'ah, which will equip us with immense blessings, immense knowledge, such as when did Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam perform his first Jum'ah? How many times did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam perform Jum'ah in their blessed life? What are the excellences of wearing the imamah, the turban, on the day of Jum'ah? And how much Durood-e Paak should we recite on the day of Friday? Alongside many other sunnahs, manners and etiquettes that we can carry out on the blessed day of Jum'ah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to act upon what has been said. Ameen, bijahin nabil, ameen. Sallu ala al-habib, sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam.
By the grace of Allah, by the grace of Allah.
Sallu ala al-habib, sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. MashaAllah, that was our Abdullah bhai. He is a teacher of Jamiatul Madina in Blackburn, Madi Sam, brothers and viewers of Madina Shalom. So those who are from Blackburn, the surrounding areas, yes, we do have a Jamiatul Madina there also. So if possible, please send your children to go and join the Jamiatul Madina in Blackburn. Those who have any children, you know, elsewhere around the United Kingdom, then they can send them to Bradford, Birmingham, mashallah, Luton also. We have places all around the country, alhamdulillah. And, you know, each and every single one of them provide free food, free fruit, subhanallah. Free, yes, fruit, isn't it? And also, my dear Islamic brothers, a free accommodation also. Those watching from America, mashallah, in Texas, we also have a Jamiatul Madina. Those watching in South Africa, there also we have more than one Jamiatul Madina. And we have it. And, you know, there may be some brothers watching in Australia also. You pray that we also open one there.
Likewise, because in Canada.
Likewise, in Canada, I forgot about, sorry.
Hopefully soon, inshallah.
Inshallah, we shall be opening one up there too. Do pray for us that we do, inshallah, continue to do the works and promote Dawat Islami so more work can be done so we can spread Islam even more. My dear seven brothers, we are speaking about hastiness, Amar bhai. We don't have too long left.
Well, we've spoken in general, you know, hastiness, how it's bad. And there are many examples of how we rush into things, we're hasty about things in our life, for example. Even when it comes to driving, you know, so many lives are lost because simply because somebody was rushing to get somewhere. Likewise, when it comes to crossing the road as well. And there are so many things in life where we're hasty, where we shouldn't be. But there are certain things in life where we are taught that it is good to be hasty. It is actually beneficial to be hasty. And what is that? Basically, you could say that good deeds. We're commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the glorious Quran, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَىٰ مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ
Allah.
And rush towards the forgiveness of your Lord and that paradise which can hold the heavens and the earth, the skies and the earth within it. And it has been prepared for the pious, for the God-fearing people, muttaqeen. And then the Quran actually even quotes Sayyidina Musa ala Nabina alayhi salatu wasalam that وَعَجِلْتُ إِلَيْكَ رَبِّي. Oh my Lord, I hastened towards you. I rushed towards you. لِتَرْضَى, so that you become pleased, so that I please you. So when it comes to good deeds, like let's say you decide, I'm going to recite durood salawat upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 313 times on a daily basis.
I'll leave it till tonight.
And then you say, oh, you know what, tomorrow, I'll start tomorrow. No, don't leave it till tomorrow. This is a good deed. Go towards it quickly. Don't delay good deeds. Now, in fact, even if you can't hit your 313 marks, at least, you know, do something. Recite a certain amount. Don't just leave the recitation until tomorrow, totally. So when it comes to even, you know, like your chance, you have a chance to recite the Quran, go for it, recite it. When it's time to pray salah, go and pray. But when you are performing salah, when you are reciting the Quran, don't be hasty then.
Allah.
Don't be hasty then. This is one of those things which is not a praised act, which is a condemned act, which is something that we we shouldn't do. For example, there are examples of those things which we shouldn't be hasty towards. Like we find one example would be hastiness in ma'azallah, cursing people, you know, doing dua and supplication against people, against parents, against their own children. Children when they're agitated Allah, against Allah, their Allah. Own parents. The Quran mentions, وَيَدْعُ الْإِنسَانُ بِالشَّرِّ دُعَاءَهُ بِالْخَيْرِ وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ عَجُولًا. That a human being, a man, he prays for evil just the same way he asks for goodness. And indeed, man, human being is hasty.
Allah, Allah.
So hastiness in supplicating against other people, you know, the parents in particular, because the Prophet ﷺ has also said, لَا تَدْعُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ وَلَا تَدْعُوا عَلَىٰ أَوْلَادِكُمْ وَلَا تَدْعُوا عَلَىٰ أَمْوَالِكُمْ
Allah.
لَا تُوَافِقُوا مِنَ اللَّهِ سَاعَةً يُسْأَلُ فِيهَا عَطَاءٌ فَيَسْتَجِيبُ لَكُمْ Allahu Akbar. That do not pray against, supplicate against yourselves. Do not supplicate against your children. Do not supplicate against your wealth. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid, it may be a time, a moment of acceptance Allah. Where you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something and it is accepted.
Allah, Allah.
So this is something that we need to be careful of.
Especially for parents, this
for
is
parents in particular.
Yeah. Some views of the child, you know, don't, you know, if your son makes a mistake, if he does something wrong, then you should, you know, tell him off that, you know, he's done something wrong. But do not curse him. Don't say, oh, you did this, may you be mazala cursed, or may this happen to you, may that happen to you. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. And listen, brothers, what if that is the time of acceptance and your dua is to be accepted? You know, many of us complain about problems in our homes, then this could be the reason, because this, astaghfirullah al-Azim, mazala, it is so prominent, really, amongst our family, our culture, etc., where the parents, you know, they curse their own children. Do not do bad dua. Do not curse your own children. You know, encourage your children to do good and have patience. Because if you are to curse them, then no matter how bad they are now, they shall be a lot worse tomorrow. No, my dear seven brothers, that is not the way. The way is to teach your children whilst they are young, grant them an Islamic upbringing. This is what's important, my dear seven brothers and viewers of Manichal, you're watching Rise and Shine. We don't have very long. We are speaking about being hasty. Remember, you know, there is good haste and bad haste at the same time. The good haste, you know, you should be hasty for some things. For example, you should, you know, be hasty in reciting your salah. You should quickly recite your salah. So late, you don't become lazy. You know, if you are tired, you might fall asleep. No, quickly recite your prayer, my dear brothers. But whilst you're reciting your prayer, do not be hasty. Meaning, be quick to initiate, to begin your prayer, but perform your prayer slowly, with humility the way it should be. Be hasty in reciting, in initiating the recitation of the Quran, but recite the Quran slowly. Yes, you should quickly go towards good things, but when it comes to bad things, then you need to, you know, sit back and contemplate and ponder, you know, what I am going to do. You should consult people. You should have mashawara, consult your elders before you are going to make a big decision. Don't be hasty. Why? فَإِنَّهَا تُثْمِرُ النَّدَامَ Because by being hasty, this only gives the fruit of regret. Amar bhai, we've got 2 minutes before we finish.
So hastiness, like you've said, you know, there is bad hastiness, there is good hastiness with hastiness towards good deeds. Another example of hastiness which we find, the Prophet ﷺ mentioned, that the one that you mentioned, you know, salah, there was a person who prayed near the Prophet ﷺ, and the Prophet ﷺ, he says to him at the end, irji' fasalli fa innaka lam tusalli. That go and repeat your prayer again.
Can't remember mentioning that.
No, you mentioned hastiness in salah.
Right.
So I'm just saying, this is an example we find from the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that go and return and pray because you have not prayed. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught him the method of prayer, that when you stand up, you know, stand peacefully first, don't rush, and so on and so forth. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam directly taught us this. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us with regards to dua. You know, we perform supplication and then we expect instant results I did this yesterday, today I don't have the results. The Prophet ﷺ, he says, يُسْتَجَابُ لِأَحَدِكُمْ مَا لَمْ يَعْجَلْ Your prayer shall be accepted so long as he does not rush, he's not hasty. يَقُولْ قَدْ دَعَوْتُ رَبِّي فَلَمْ يَسْتَجَبْ لِي that I supplicated in the court of my Lord, but he has not answered my prayer. So don't be hasty in having your prayers accepted.
Have patience, my dear brothers and viewers on the channel. Keep on praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No doubt Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts our prayers in various manners, my dear brothers and viewers of the channel. For that, alhamdulillah, you know, we've had a separate program, haven't we? When we spoke about dua, continue to pray in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Du'a'u mukhul ibadah. Dua is the essence of worship. That's all for now, my dear brothers and viewers of the channel. Don't forget, we shall be back on Monday. Join Rise and Shine on Monday, inshallah, azza wa jal, live. Sallu ala al-habib, sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam.
By the grace of Allah, by the grace of Allah, even the darkest night will end, and the sun will rise and shine. And the sun will rise and shine. By the grace of Allah.